carrying something greater. Child of God, I want to tell you, it is not by your power, it is not by your mighty, but by the Spirit of the Lord. Do not look at your status, at your condition. Just continue to believe in God, that in God is there for you, and he is ready to fight all your battles. David never gave Goliath the advantage over him. Do not give the devil the advantage over you. He focused on
praise the mighty name of the Lord. I greet you, my dear viewers, from wherever you are watching us from. My name is Richard Muchangi. I minister with Full Gospel Churches of Kenya, located in Githurai 45 in Nairobi. And I want to take this wonderful opportunity to welcome you to the ministry of the Word of God, because the Word of God is God himself. It has power to change, it has power to transform, and it has power to do great and mighty things. This wonderful moment of time, I want to speak to us about the power of decrees and declarations. The power of decrees and declaration. I want you to know that God has given us a very powerful tool that is called our mouth. And we can use our mouth to create the kind of the world that we want to live in. Therefore, when you use your mouth positively, then you get positive result. When you use your mouth negatively, you get negative result. There is power in decrees. There is power in declarations. The one in the book of Job chapter 22 and verses 28, the Bible says, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the right shall sign upon thy ways. You shall decree a thing, and shall be established. The words that you speak with your mouth, they are very powerful. I always say that our words are both have power to create or to destroy. You can create the future that you want to experience by the words of your mouth. And the Bible says, you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. Therefore, teach yourself to be speaking positively, to be speaking prophetically. You know, your declaration should always be based upon the Word of God. Therefore, you are not going to declare anything that is outside the will of God, but your declarations must be established and based on the Word of God. And whenever you decree, you cause your decree to be established. So the moment you decree a thing, then you cause that decree to be established. You can remember in the book of Genesis chapter 1, if you can go verses 3, the Bible says, and God said, let there be light. When the world was formless, without light, and darkness was hovering over the face of the earth, the Bible says that God said, let there be light, and there was light. He declared whatever you wanted to see. Therefore, when you decree according to the Word of God, your mouth has power to create, because men are both created and creative. You can create your own world. You can create your happiness. You can create your miracles by the words of your mouth. There are people that have, you know, bewitched themselves by the words of their mouth. When you say, I am a failure, when you say, I am a loser, when you keep on saying, I cannot make it, when you say, things are not good, what are you doing? You are creating your own failures. But when you speak positively, you know, the Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong, and let the poor say, I am rich. So you are not expecting to talk about your current affairs, about the circumstances, the happenings, but men of faith, they speak of the expected result. You speak of what you want to see. God never talked about the darkness that was there at the moment. He did not talk about the way the world was formless, but he spoke of what he wanted to see. Therefore, from now onward, speak the way you want things to appear. Create the miracles that you want to have. And I want to say this, it means that when we speak, the right of God will come, because the Bible has clearly said that and the right shall sign upon thy way. Therefore, we say the right will come because you have decreed a light that comes as a result of decreeing the Word of God. Now, number one, you need to declare the Word of God. As I have said, you don't just decree aimlessly. You don't just decree from your mouth or from your mind. but you decree the word of God. You need to know the word so that you may know the promises. In the word of God in the Bible, there are more than 7,000 promises that God has given to the church, and you can decree, you can claim those promises. If the Bible says you shall not be above only and not be near, you can speak that word over your life. If the Bible says through the stripes of Jesus we were healed, you can decree that word time and again, saying that I am healed. If the word of God says that we will live life to the maximum, it doesn't matter what people are saying and the predictions of people, but you declare the word of God. You remember the servant of God David, he said, I shall not die, but I shall live to declare the praises of the Lord. So the more you know the word of God, you will continue to decree the word of God. The Bible says that the leeches and wealth will never leave our houses. That's a word that you need to decree. You can decree the word over your children, where the Bible says that our children will be taught of the Lord, and in great will be their peace. The Bible says our sons and our daughters will be great upon the earth. So it's not your time to curse your children. It is your time, even when they are not performing well in school, you say they are genius. You say they have the wisdom of God. In the book of Isaiah 43:26, the Bible says, put me in remembrance, let us plead together, declare thou that thou may be justified. So you have to declare, you have to declare the word of God. It is the will of God and his earnest desire for you and I to declare his word back to him, the word that the Lord has spoken, the word that God has said. You declare that word back to him. In the book of Jeremiah 1:11, God is telling Jeremiah that I am watching over my word, that I may ask them to fulfill it. Therefore, you need to repeat the word of God, the word that God has spoken over your life. You need to keep on repeating that word, and by so doing, you are creating life to your life. God relates to us on the basis of his word. God will always relate to you on the basis of his word. When you keep on repeating the word of God, when you keep on saying, I am blessed and not cursed, because God is watching over his word, that he may ask them to perform it. God has obligated himself to the fulfillment of his word. What a great revelation that God has obligated himself to the fulfillment of his word. Therefore, when you speak that word, when you internalize that word, when you personalize that word, you make the word of God part and parcel of your life. Don't open your ears to hear what the people are saying, but you need to focus and concentrate on the word of God. In the book of Joshua 1:8, God is speaking to Joshua that the words of the book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, and by so doing you shall have prosperity and have good success. When you keep on meditating on the word of God, when you keep on rehearsing the word of God, speaking the word of God, speaking the promises of God, getting God at his word, because the Bible says he is faithful. Let all men become liars, but he will remain faithful. Whatever he has said, he is going to perform it. And I want to see in the book, I've talked about Jeremiah 1:12, that thou hast seen well, for I will ask him to perform my word. When you do the word of God, when you speak the word of God, when you declare the word of God. Therefore, I'm challenging you from wherever you are watching me from, continue to declare the word of God over your life, over your situation. When you declare the word, God is faithful. He honors his word. The Bible says, Psalms 138:2, that I will bless and magnify the Lord who has exalted his word Father above all his name. He has exalted his word above all his names. Therefore, when you keep on declaring the word, declare it over your life, speak the way God speaks. And I want to tell you, by so doing, you are going to get result. You are going to be established. That is why Job could stand and say that I know that my Redeemer liveth, and one day he will stand for me. Continue to speak that word. Continue to declare according to the word of God. And number two, declare over your life. Declare things over your life. Psalms 118 verse 17, the Bible says, I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. Therefore, declare things over your life. Speak life over your life. Now, God has literally given you the right and the privilege to declare life over your life. You are given right, you are given privilege to declare life over your life. Speak of the health, speak of prosperity, speak of good life, speak of riches and wealth, speak of doors of opportunity. Whatever you want God to do in your life, you know, you have to give God access. The Bible says the heaven and the highest heaven belongs to God, but the heart he has given to the sons of men. Therefore, it is our duty and our obligation to involve God by decreeing being. Remember, God will not force his way to you. You are the one to invite God. Even when Jesus was teaching his disciples on the power of prayer and on how to pray, this is what he said, let your kingdom come down. Therefore, you are the one to tell God to let his kingdom to come down. Speak over your life. You know, the scripture implies that the works of the Lord is reason enough to stay alive and to defy premature death. The works of the Lord. And that's why David is saying, I shall not die but live to declare the works of the Lord. Therefore, when you understand this element of the works of the Lord, it is enough reason for you to stay. If you don't want to die a premature death, if you don't want to die untimely death, you need to purpose to work and serve God. You need to purpose to always declare the works of God. You need to be on assignment, because when you are on assignment, the kingdom will fund you, the kingdom will protect you. I want to tell you, child of God, from wherever you are watching us from, serving God is not in vain. It comes with the privileges, and that is why David is saying, I shall not die but live to declare the works of the Lord. Life is in the declaration of the works of the Lord. Yes, what a great revelation. Life is in the declarations of the works of the Lord. Whenever you keep on declaring the works of the Lord, whenever you keep on talking of the greatness of God, calling sinners to the salvation, and encouraging the people of God, speaking of the mighty works of God, then there is life in that. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 18 and the verses 21, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat its fruit thereof. Therefore, when you continue to declare, you know, there is power in your mouth. Death and life are in the power of your tongue. When you use your mouth wisely, when you use your mouth in a positive way, then there is life in your tongue. And even death is in your tongue. There are many people who have killed themselves because of the negative use of their tongues. But when you use your tongue positively, I want to tell you, you have what it takes. Tongue is a very strong tool. It's a great force. It can dictate the course of your life. It can make things to be better or to be worse. Take care of your mouth. And now another thing you need to declare, even in the face of your giants. Declare in the face of your giant. Many a times we are faced by many challenges, like the giant that is facing us, in our days, the giant of COVID-19, it's a very huge giant, but you can declare in the face
off your giant. You can tell every giant that is facing your life that I have what it takes. That you giant, you are not going to kill me, but I am killing you in the name of Jesus. In the 1 Samuel chapter 17, verses 46, we see the servant of God David, and this is what he is telling the giant. This day will the Lord deliver thee into mine hand, and I will smite thee and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistine this day unto the foes of the hair and the wild beast on of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is God in Israel. David is telling Goliath that even though you are a giant, even though you are big in stature, I am coming to you, and this day I will give your friends even to the host and to the bands of the hair. I have come to tell you, declare in the face of your giant. Even when you are attacked by a sickness, don't start saying that I'm going to die, but you need to tell that sickness, you sickness, you don't have power in my body. I overcome you. You know, the Bible says they overcame him by the power of the blood and the conversion of their testimony. When you speak the word of God, when you speak it prophetically, you are going to overcome by the conversion of your mouth. David told Goliath, I am coming to you in the name of the Lord. You, Goliath, you are coming to me with spears and with sword, but I am coming to you in the name of the Lord. I have come to tell you, child of God, it doesn't matter the giants that are rising against you. They are coming to you carrying many names. It can be called coronavirus, it can be called cancer, it can be called heart failure, any kind of a disease. They can come bearing the names of poverty, but I have come to tell you, as a servant of God, you can confront every giant of your life in the mighty name of the Lord. You can face and silence those giants. When Goliath is telling David that am I a dog that you young boy, you are coming to me with some stones, he is belittling and humiliating David. But in David, in his heart, he is telling Goliath, you are too big that I cannot miss you, that I am ready. Therefore, child of God, you can purpose to remain optimistic at every situation. Even in the tunnel of darkness, you can see the light of God at the end of every tunnel. Therefore, confront your Goliath, confront your giant. Some people declare what they see, while others declare what they desire to see. We are not going to declare what we see, but we're gonna declare what we want to see. Like now, as a church, we are declaring that the God of the church, it is a God that we serve. We are declaring that the church gonna receive back the nation of Kenya and the nations of the world. They're gonna come back to normalcy. We decree prophetically that COVID-19 will not destroy us. It is a huge giant, but we are telling COVID-19, we conquer you now by the blood of Jesus and by the words of our mouth. We declare we have what it takes. Child of God, you are not going to die. You will live to decree the praises of the Lord. You can declare victory over your family. You can declare victory over your business. You can say, I am a winner and not a loser. You can declare and say, I am appointed and not disappointed. You can say, the Lord is raising me from the grass to the grace. Declare in the face of your giant. Now, notice that in David's declaration, it was specific to action, time, outcomes, and the purpose. Yet that in David's declaration, it was specific to action, time, outcomes, and the purpose. So he was specific that what he was declaring, he was taking an action. It was a right time. He was expecting good outcome. It was purposeful. Many believers are afraid to declare like David did because they are not convinced that the word in them will work. I have come across many believers. They know the word of God, but they are afraid of speaking. They are not as courageous as David, because Because they ask himself, what if I declare it and it fail to happen? I have come to tell you, our God is faithful. We are not but guessing, but we know, we have attested of this God. There are many things that we have ever declared, and they have come to be a reality. Therefore, you can declare the word of God. You can declare without fear that the word will work. Can I assure you, the word will work. Whenever you speak the word of God, God will facilitate. The angels of God will be activated. There are many things that we have ever declared in life. And I want to tell you, we have seen God doing. I can remember in my life when I was young, when I was a young man, just riding a bicycle, you know, without anything. And one day I visited the place of my sister on a borrowed bicycle. I was riding, I was tired, sweating, and I remember telling my sister, today I have come in your place riding a borrowed bicycle, but I want to assure you, one day I'll come driving my own car. And my sister just loved not in a good way, she just loved that. But I want to assure you, after many or few years, I went there driving my own car, because the ones creates the expected result. Therefore, do not be afraid of declaring the work of the Lord, because God will surely come and he will do. In the book of Mark chapter 11, verses 23, the Bible says, for verily I say unto you, that whatsoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he says. This is Jesus Christ, and he is saying, I tell you for sure, whoever will speak to this mountain, thou be cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, it shall come to pass. It doesn't matter, child of God, the kind of the mountain that you are confronting. It may be opposition, it may be poverty, it may be challenges of life, but I have come to tell you, you can speak to that mountain. The time has come where we need to stop telling our God how we experiencing certain great and huge mountains, but we can confront our mountains and tell our mountains, we serve a big God. You can command that mountain to move. And I want to tell you, child of God, I am a witness of this, that the kind of God that we serve, in the book of Ephesians chapter 3 and verses 20, the Bible says, he is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we think or imagine or even ask, according to the power that works in us. There is a great power that God has bestowed in you, in your mouth, in your tongue. Psalm says that he has given power in the mouth of elephant and babies to silence the enemy. We are the children of God, and in our mouth he has established power to silence the enemy. Use that power to declare things in your life. Another thing, you need to declare under pressure. Declare under pressure. Even when you are in pressure, declare the word of God. Declare the works of God. In the book of Daniel chapter 3 verses 16 through 18, we see these three guys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, answered and said to the king, O King Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. If it may be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine aid, O king. They spoke with the power, and they told the king that our God is able to deliver us. And they said, we are not careful to answer you, because our God whom we serve, he has power to deliver us. They were not guessing. They were not saying that he will not deliver us, but they were telling the king, even though you change your mind and say you are not going to put that in the fire, fire, we will not bow and worship you. The enemy uses pressure to keep you threatened and silent. Do not allow the pressure of the enemy, because at times he will use pressure to keep you threatened and silent. We are not going to be silent. Don't allow twisters to silence you. Don't allow pressure. Even under pressure, you can decree and say, I am a winner. I am victorious. I am blessed. The enemy knows that if he can keep you threatened, then he can keep you quiet. When he keep you threatened, he will make sure that you are quieter. When fear is removed, threat do not work. You need to listen to this. When fear is removed, threat do not work. Child of God, do not live a life of fear. Do not live a life of intimidation. Do not be humiliated. Do not be threatened. You know, the Bible says that we should not fear, because greater is he who is in us than the one who is in the world. Therefore, do not allow the spirit of fear, because when fear is removed, then threats do not have power in our lives. And God is faithful. He is going to do great things. A man or woman that trusts in God will say things other people cannot say. When you are a man of God, you will be able to say things that other people cannot say. Declare the victory before it comes, because God has already promised that the victory belongs to you and not to the devil. Shout in advance of the walls coming down. Let me tell you, child of God, as we come to pray together, declare your victory even before it comes. Do not wait until the time the victory has come. Joshua and the people of Israel, they celebrated the war of Jericho even before it comes. Therefore, child of God, I want to bless you. I want to pray with you, because our God is faithful. Our God is mighty. We have talked about the power of decrees and declarations. And I began by saying, declare the word of God, then declare it over your life, declare in the face of your giant, and declare under pressure. I want to pray with you. I know maybe you're experiencing challenges, but our God is faithful. Our God is able. Continue to declare and continue to decree, and you're going to see God doing great things in your life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you. I pray with my dear listeners and my viewers from wherever they are watching me from, and I pray, mighty Father, that from this time onward, they are going to declare your word. They are going to raise decrees and declarations, and great things are going to happen. Them that are sick, I decree healing upon their bodies, in the mighty name of the Lord. We thank you, we honor you, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. If you are there and you are not born again, I invite you to give your life to Jesus. Just repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I am a sinner. I ask you to forgive me. And from today, I am your son. In Jesus' name, I pray. May the Lord bless you. You can continue to honor God by giving your offering, by supporting this program, by paying your tither, and you can use the PayBill number, that is 699-350, and the Lord will continue to bless you. Shalom, peace, until we meet again. We'll be right back.